Do you know that there are four types of intelligences? Average person knows only one type of intelligence, and that is intelligence quotient, IQ. Today in this video, I will talk about four types of intelligences and then how you can use these intelligence to make yourself better. And those people who have kids, those people who have kids around them or their own children must listen this video. So without wasting any time, I will talk about the four type of intelligences and how you can develop these type of intelligences in the kids around you and how you can improve your own intelligence of these four types. The first one, I'm sure you know, is the IQ, intelligence quotient, and it helps people in solving the math problems, in doing the analytical things. So it also helps people in memorizing the things. Those people who can memorize the things and solve the mathematical problems are considered as highly intelligent people, having the IQ, having the high IQ. Well, the latest research says that the other type of intelligence which is important than IQ is EQ, that is emotional intelligence. Emotional quotient means that you have the ability to interact the people in positive way. You have the ability to handle the sad things in a positive way. So this is emotional quotient. All those people who built businesses, who are the billionaires, they have higher EQ. And the third type of intelligence is the social intelligence. Social intelligence is the type of intelligence which helps the people in maintaining the relationships. Those people who have higher social intelligence, they can keep the friendships for the longer run. They have better relationships with their family, with their friends. And the fourth type of intelligence is that the adversity quotient. Adversity quotient means that you came up with something bad, you had a very bad event in your life, and those people who get out from that stage very early are called to have the adversity quotient. So now you are aware about four types of intelligences. How to build these intelligences? Well, analytical skills you can build through solving mathematical problems, through doing the practice of memorizing by reading things. Similarly, in emotional quotient, you can read the book of Emotional Intelligence by Daniel Goleman. It is available on my YouTube channel. You can follow the complete process. But the main thing is that emotional quotient is all about understanding yourself and what things can provoke you, on what things you get angry, on what things you become happy. Once you know your limitations, once you know your background, then you easily handle the circumstances. Let's say there is one practice that whenever you're getting angry, you can write down on paper that I am angry. The moment you wrote it, then you will never become angry. Then you will not react. You know that now I am angry. So that is kind of emotional quotient. And for the social quotient, for the social intelligence, you need to understand that whenever you are in the social gatherings, you need to listen to the people. There is one book, The 7 Habits of Highly Successful People, The 8 Habits of Successful People. This book summary is available on my YouTube channel. You can see the complete process. But the main point is that socially, in order to be understood, you need to first listen to the others. And then there is another book on my YouTube channel, which is The Laws of Understanding Human Nature. You will understand the people, what people want from you. You can watch these summaries from my YouTube channel. And the fourth part is extremely important for the children. And that is how to get out of the bad situations, how to get out of a sad event. These days, we are facing the suicide from the students, and most of the people get mad when they lose their parents or something bad happened in their life, and they do not get up very easily from that stage. Some of the people become alcoholic, and the reason is that they're not taught about the realities of the life. Most of us think that the people dying around us, only they are dying, we will not die. Although we accept it that death is the ultimate reality, but somehow in our mind we keep this thing on the backside. But this is the biggest reality of life. And no matter what is the situation in your life, that is going to pass. So whenever you're in a sad situation, you should remember that this time will pass. I have seen the people, I'm sure you also observed the people who lost their parents, but after 1 year, after 2 years, they get good opportunities, like they have kids, and then they are living a normal life. So there are some things, some facts in the life, and the best way to cope up with these problems is to have the faith on God. So the Muslims, there is a reason that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that Muslims, they do not feel the hopelessness. We cannot be hopeless. Because why? Because Muslims think that whatever is happening to them is happening because of will of God. And if there is some sad thing, if there is some good thing where they cannot do anything, let's say loss of parents, you cannot do anything. Let's say if somebody is failing after trying his best in the MBBS, he cannot do anything. Then he must leave the things on the plan of God. And what happens is that you have to give your best. You should never hesitate giving your best. If you're not giving best to anything, then there comes your own IQ, your EQ. You have to improve that thing. But if you have done whatever you could, so let's say you, for the MBBS, you studied 18 hours. You studied more than all of your friends. You studied the best pattern, but still you could not secure an admission. Still you could not pass. Then there is no issue. It means that there is something which God is planning for you. It means that there is something in which you are skilled and you will become successful in that field more compared to the MBBS. So this thing we need to teach our children. And the other thing is that for adversity quotient, you need to teach the children that failure is part of the journey. So one single failure from the exam does not mean that your whole life failure. So these are the things which you need to understand as a person. You need to teach your kids as a person. So I'm sure today, after watching this video, you know more about the type of intelligences, and you will be able to improve the intelligence of your kids. One thing more I would like to say is that those people who are high EQ and higher SQ, social quotient and emotional quotient, are the mostly successful people, because our IQ is derived by the social quotient. And this is what Bill Gates said, that three things you need any human: integrity, intelligence, and the energy. If one does not have the integrity, then all the things ruin him. The intelligence will ruin him, the energy will ruin him. And you get the integrity through emotional quotient and social quotient. If you liked the video, please share it with others. Let's have a larger community. Please do watch all other book summaries. I'm sure you'll find the content useful. Thank you so much.